are you?
That's good.
Are you here for an appointment?
Okay.
This is your first time here.
Okay, that's fine.
Do you happen to have your driver's license and your insurance card, please?
Thank you.
Alright. So, let's see here. I'm just gonna take down your information from your license, your name. Let me see, pull it up here. Is the address on your license still your current address? Okay. Alright. Alright, date of birth. Okay. Thank you. Let's go ahead with this. This is a very interesting insurance card. Okay, that's fine. I'm not sure if we take this insurance. I'm gonna check for you, okay? One second. Let me look in our system. Okay, yes, we do take this insurance. So you're good. There will just be a small copay at the end, that's all. Just put this information for you. The policy number. And you are all set. All right. I do have a couple of very quick questions for you, just for our information, so that the doctor can review this before the doctor meets with you, and she will discuss whatever potential problems that you have, or this could be just a routine checkup, whatever it is. So we just wanted to ask you what the purpose of your visit is. Okay. So, it's a routine visit, and you're having some problems with dry eyes and tiredness. Okay. Well, the doctor will definitely look into that for you. Is there anything else? Okay. We also just want to ask very quickly a very brief synopsis of your eye health history. So, the first question is, have you ever had eye surgery? Do you remember how old you were? Okay. Do you know what the surgery was for? Okay. It's trying to straighten your eyes out. Okay. Have you ever had any other issues, maybe with blurriness or loss of vision or anything like that? Does anyone in your family have a similar issue, eye issue, to what you have? Okay. Do you know which relative or relatives? Okay. Okay. Thank you. That's all I needed on my end. So if you just please be seated, and the doctor will be with you shortly, okay? Thank you. Hello. I'm doctor, not a doctor. How you doing? Okay. Yes, that is a strange name. I hear it all the time. How are you? This is your first time here. Okay. I do want to let you know, we relocated, so this is a new office. And we are still going through a bit of a construction phase, a little moving in phase. So because of that, please forgive what seems like a lack of technology. We only have the bare minimum here. I know you saw the receptionist before and she had a laptop, but the typical projectors that we would use for your eye charts, things like that, haven't been shipped from the old office to this office yet. You will still get a quality exam, but we're gonna do it the old-fashioned way with paper, okay? All right, so the receptionist gave me your paperwork, and it says here that you are having some problems with dry eyes and with tiredness, your eyes just being tired. Do you experience blurriness when your eyes are tired like that? Okay. All right. How often do your eyes get red and they feel tired? All right. Did you notice if they typically do that after a certain activity, maybe you're on the computer for a really long time, watching something, or you stayed up too long? Anything like that? Maybe playing video games? Yeah, definitely looking at the devices, it's not necessarily a bad thing, but like with anything in excess, it can be. So we definitely recommend that you not watch it at night, but even if you have to, say for instance, if your job is a night job and you have to be on the computer for whatever reason, you can't say to your boss, no, I can't do the job because my doctor said no. You can still do it, but maybe have a blue light filter, or you could consciously blink more, because usually when we're focusing on something that deeply, we tend to forget that we need to blink and rehydrate our eyes. So just keep that in the back of your mind. It might actually help in the future. Thankfully, these are pretty minor concerns. I know they feel uncomfortable and they're not minor because you feel them, but there's a lot worse things that can happen to your eyes than just redness and tiredness, and these can be easily fixed as well, so that's good. All right. Okay. Do you have any questions or further concerns that you'd like to discuss with me before we begin? So we're going to start. Like I said, we're under construction, we're still moving in, so the charts that you normally would see, the projections that we normally easily show you, I'm gonna have to do everything manually, so please bear with me, okay? I'm gonna put this down. I'm gonna go grab a chart for us. I know you have those problems that you want us to address. However, since you're a new patient with me, I need to test and make sure that your overall vision is good and that those conditions aren't from a deeper cause than just normal wear and tear. So we're gonna start with a visual acuity test. Now I'm going to tape this to the wall. So I'm gonna tape it to the wall. I just want you to look comfortably ahead at this chart. We are going to go through different lines to see how well. I'm gonna move my chair. Alright. So we're going to go through the chart to see how much of this you can read. Please don't squint your eyes or lean forward or anything like that to try to see better. We want to know how well you can see without any of that. Also, please take off your glasses. You can hold them in your lap just so we can see how your vision is normally without corrections, okay? So we're gonna start with line one. And yes, I'm using a cotton swab for this. It just felt appropriate. So for line one, what letter do you see? It is an E. How about line three? Can you read line three, please, from left to right? Yes, that's a T. Yeah, an O, and a C. Okay. Line five. And this one. Okay. All right. Can you read line four for me? Okay. I'm going to record those observations in my notes. All right. Yes, each line actually tells you roughly how well you can see in comparison to people with 20/20 vision or perfect vision. So this green line right here after line six shows you that if you can read this line, you have 20/20 vision, or at least if you can read the majority of the letters on that line, you have 20/20 vision. Anything beyond this, your vision is phenomenal. It is better than 20/20. People who have LASIK surgery, for example, may actually be able to see beyond 20/20 vision. For the majority of people, you will be above this green line. You will be somewhere most likely in this range. The reason being that if you cannot read this top letter, you are considered legally blind. So this base is off the fact that you are about 20 feet away from the chart. And a person with 20/20 vision can read all of these with relative ease. However, each line compares to how far away you need to be approximately to see theirs with the same clarity as someone with 20/20 vision. Please bear in mind though, don't feel bad if you have trouble with any of the letters. If you need glasses, most likely you do have trouble with some of the letters. That's completely fine. This is just one way to test your visual acuity, how well you can see. So it's not foolproof method by any means. So please don't feel bad if you can't read it well. Me personally, I have trouble seeing the C's because they look like O's to me, and sometimes they look like G's. Now there are no G's at all in this chart, but you will hear me say G. Especially when I was a child, you would hear me say G when I would see these letters because it would confuse me. They would blur and I'd be like, I don't know, it looks like a G to me. But yeah, that was the first test. I do have another test, just to kind of double check that first test. So this is called the Tumbling E Test. It does a similar, it tests something similar to what that other chart did. However, with this one, The way you do it is a little different. One more. All right. Now for this one, as you can probably see to a certain degree, these are all E's, the letter E, but they're the three, the trine part is facing a different direction. So what I want you to do is either say the direction that it's facing, right, left, up, or down, or you can point in the direction that you see it in when I point to each of the E's, okay? So we are going to start at line three. What direction is it? Try line five. Line five. Okay, this one. All right. Just as a double check, about line nine, line four. Just gonna make a note of that. You can put your glasses back on. The next test we are going to do doesn't involve the wall anymore. Have this binder, and what we're going to do is I'm going to show you different images, and for those images I want you to tell me what you see. It may be nothing, it may be a particular number, it could be lines, whatever you see, but I'll talk you through it as we go, okay? So this, we will start the very first one. And what do you see, if anything, in this one? A 12, yes. Correct. All right. Now for this next one. Mm-hmm. What do you see in this one? Mm-hmm. What about this one? It's okay, take your time. Mm-hmm. For this one, we're gonna do it a little differently, okay? I want you to tell me the colors that you see, if you see lines. So if there are lines in this image, tell me their colors. Mm-hmm. Just the color of the lines. Okay. And last one, I promise. Okay. Yep. Very good. It's orange. Very good. So that was a color blindness test. So it's to determine if you are colorblind, and if you are colorblind, what type of color blindness you have. So let me write down your results and my observations. Okay. Yes. Different forms of color blindness, but the most common is red-green color blindness. And not all color blindness is a sex-linked gene, which means that it goes on the sex chromosomes. So for a woman, XX, for a man, XY. However, red-green color blindness typically is sex-linked, and that's why men typically tend to have it more than women. Because if, for instance, your mother has either is colorblind and or she is a carrier of colorblindness, so one of her X's in her chromosomes, one of them has the colorblindness gene, which is a recessive gene, which normally can get masked if there is something dominant over it. However, because it's only on the X chromosome, it only will go on the X chromosome. A man only has one X chromosome, women have two. So a woman is more likely to, maybe if her father is not colorblind at all, he won't give her colorblindness. The mother may give her the carrier gene, so she may also carry it, so she may give it to her children too. Or she may not, depending, you know, it's genetics, it depends. It's all a gamble. But if that mother gave her son that X chromosome, he will immediately be colorblind in some way because he doesn't have that X, that extra X to make to trump the recessive gene. And his father can only give him a Y to make him a male. So, because the father is the only one who has the Y to give. And because of that, men tend to be colorblind more often than women. Yes. That was kind of the general overview on that one. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to take a little flashlight, okay? And I want you to look straight ahead, directly at my nose, okay? Don't follow the light, just look directly at me. Ready? Making sure your eyes dilate properly. All right. Now, the next thing we're going to do is I want you to follow the light. So I want to see how well your eyes move. So now I want you to actually follow the light just with your eyes, not with your head. Just your eyes. Okay? Just your eyes. Ready? What we're going to do is I'm going to test your peripheral vision and see how far your field of vision is, how far up to the sides and up you, your eyes can see. So once again, I want you to look at my nose, so just look straight at my nose, don't look at anything else. And I'm going to show you different numbers in different locations, and I want you to tell me what number you're seeing. Are you ready? Okay. So. Okay. Now we're going to test your peripheral vision one more time. I'm going to take my fingers and I'm going to go out this way and I'm going to go up this way. And I want you to tell me when you cannot see my fingers anymore. Okay? Ready? Okay, here we go. Alright. And. Okay. We're going to do that. Of your test so far. Okay. Beautiful. Now, how long has it been since you've had new glasses? Okay. Do you mind if I take a look at them? I'm just gonna grab them. Do they feel okay when you wear them? Okay. How about these frames? Do they seem too small to you? Too big? We'd rather have them bigger this way instead of this way. Okay. How do you feel about the wire frames? And the typical silicone nose pieces. Okay. So you are interested in getting new glasses? Okay. I'll give these back to you. There you go. We want to check if your prescription has changed at all. So we're going to do yet another test. Okay. This time, though, I want you to remove your glasses. And just keep them in your lap if you wish. You can put them on the side table, whatever works for you. And I'm going to put certain frames in front of your eyes, different glasses, and I want you to tell me what you can see. All right, what line we're reading. So I'm going to put this up. These lines are numbered, but it's the first line, second, third, and fourth. Okay? Now I'm going to grab my frames. And like I said, it's gonna be manual, so I'm gonna go behind you, okay? And I'm going to ask you to close one of your eyes. So close one of your eyes. And with the other, I want you to look through this. Be the first line for me. Alright. And is it better or worse? Okay. Can you read the second line for me, please? Okay. Now is this better or worse? Okay. Now you can close this eye and you can open this eye, please. Okay? Ready? Do the same thing. Alright. Can you read the third line for me, please? Okay. And? Is that better or worse? Okay. Ready? One more time. Can you read the fourth line for me, please? Okay. And? Better or worse? Okay. Very good. Alright. I'm gonna take this off the wall. Prescription has changed just a little bit. It's not going to change very much. So, no, your eyes aren't getting ridiculously worse or anything like that. They're just slightly adjusted to sharpen your vision just a little bit more. Were you interested in seeing any of the glasses that we carry here, or did you want to get glasses elsewhere? You want to take a look at them? Okay, yeah. I have a couple samples. So based on the glasses that you wear, I'm assuming you want something similar, but you don't want the wire glasses anymore. You want the plastic, kind of like what I'm wearing right now. Yeah. Okay, that's fine. We can do that. So what do you think of this pair? These are black, and they're very basic. They don't have embellishments like yours do on the side or anything like that, and like mine do, but they're perfect for everyday wear. They match everything. Very classic and stylish. And they have a similar frame shape to what you're wearing. They're just a little bit bigger. a little bit wider. So what do you think of these? They even have plastic nose pieces, so you don't have any issues with those other ones moving around or falling off or anything like that. These will stay in place and they're very sturdy. Would you like to try them on? Okay. So if you want to take yours off. Okay. And ready? Okay. I think these suit your face shape really well. What do you think? That is a good point. It is hard to know if you look good when you can't see well without your normal prescription. Yeah, these are non-prescription. Mm-hmm. I know, you kind of have to look at them and guess. So you want to keep these in mind? Alright, well, we'll look at the other sample pair that we have. Yes, and you would get the case with it too. Very nice, sturdy case. To keep your glasses protected. Now the second one, the case is a little squishy, but it's still, it'll still protect your glasses, okay? So we're gonna open this. And this pair is a little more bold than the other pair. It's similar, the eye shape is similar. It's a little bit wider this way than the other one, I would say. But it's very similar in eye shape because I think that suits your face better. I know when you have a certain face shape, it can be hard to find glasses that look nice. But I think these would work well for you. These have a print on the side and a bunch of flowers. So if that's not your jam, that's okay. I personally think having kind of neutral like mine is better. It just goes with everything. It's easier. But if your person likes to switch it up, this is good. It also, once again, has the plastic pieces, so you don't have that fiddling with the other nose pieces. So what do you think of these? Do you want to try them on? Yeah, ready? Yeah, no, they look good too. The thing is, because the shape is similar and it definitely seems like it's more your thing, I think they'll always kind of look good on you. So it really doesn't matter which one you select. I think they'd still work. So are you interested in any of our glasses that we carry? Are you gonna think about it? Okay. Yeah, you can think about it, that's fine. I'm gonna put this back. Alright. So there's just one more test that I'd like to do before we address the dryness issue, okay? Because I think this will show us more what you... It'll show us more if the redness and the tiredness are a deeper issue than just being how your eyes being overused. So I'm going to take some eye drops. I know. Pretty much everyone who has glasses has trauma with eye drops that I found. myself included. But they're necessary. So these are not for dryness. These are going to be a way for me to see deeper into your eyes, okay? So what we're gonna do is I'm going to uncap this, okay? Alright, now I'm gonna put these in your eyes. Just a drop or two. Okay, ready? I'm gonna open your eye. And okay, ready? I'm gonna open your eye and choo-choo. Beautiful. Blink, 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 blink. Hold on. I have a tissue for you. Okay. All right. Penny, I'm gonna tap. Close your eyes. Other side now. Okay, just to get the excess off. Alright, and I want you to blink. Okay, really in there. This is gonna take a little while to dilate your eyes so that I can check your eyes for you. We're gonna have more drops. I know. But these are going to be for redness, okay? Because I can see your eyes are a little bit irritated. Just to help alleviate that itchy dryness, we are going to give you eye drops that are meant for dryness and redness, okay? For this, I'm just going to put one. Ready? Here it comes. Ready? And I'm going to open your eyes. And ready? And okay, look, look, look. I know eye drops are hard. They definitely are. I have trouble with them myself, but sometimes you need them. Okay. Yeah, I know. It's okay. All right. So, while those eye drops are working on you, we can discuss your redness, tiredness issue a little bit more. So you were saying that you're on screens a lot. It's kind of inevitable nowadays, really. So it's not it's good to cut back if you can. If you can, so for instance, if you're always on the computer because of your job or something like that, it makes it harder to say, oh, you gotta stop doing that. Oh, you gotta cut like 5 hours out of your workday to rest your eyes. Gotta pay the bills, so no, we can't do that. And that's fine. But there are certain things you can do to try to alleviate that dryness and the tiredness of your eyes. Now, of course, one of the biggest things is sleep, getting good quality sleep. So that's easier said than done sometimes, but making it dark in your room before you go to bed, having the temperature a little cooler, but put on a lot of blankets to be nice and cozy. Things like that can help you fall asleep faster. Don't have hardcore physical exercise before you go to bed so your body's not wired. Maybe not even have anything super mentally stimulating either so that your mind is going 100 miles a minute. Just kind of settle yourself in. Maybe listen to some quiet, gentle music or something like that and have yourself settle into bed. That way you can sleep roughly your 8 hours. To help your eyes recoup from the day. Just think about it, your eyes have been working all day long. All day long. No 8 hour shift with lunch for them. So we need to take care of our eyes, and sleep is restorative for pretty much everything for us. Also, I would say that you can do simple things where if, say for instance, you're feeling they're so tired, oh my goodness, they kind of hurt me. What you can do is you can rub your hands together, create some friction, make your hands warm. And once your hands are warm, without your glasses on, you put your hands over your eyes and just breathe and relax. Let the heat seep into your eyes and help. It'll help you feel better, really will. I also, sometimes when I'm in the shower, I just let the water, the warm water, not hot water, just warm water, go over my eyes too. Give them a little refresh, a little reset. And what you can also do is set a blue light filter, like I mentioned before, on your computer, on your phone, wherever you're working, so that the blue light doesn't hurt your eyes, especially at night. But those are just some strategies. We do have eye drops too that can help if you're really in a pinch and they're just really dry, uncomfortably dry. Those might help you too. Okay. Your eyes look dilated enough. So those eye drops that I gave you at first made your pupils larger so that I can check your eyes. So I'm going to go with a light very gently on the edge. I'm not going to blind you, okay? And I'm going to look. How are your eyes feeling? Yep. Okay. Well, those other eye drops that are meant for the redness, they probably stung a little bit in the beginning. That can happen, but they'll feel a lot better, especially tomorrow once you have a nice sleep, a good sleep, and wake up, you'll feel much better. Yes, so you want to know more about the ribbon. Yeah, that is definitely a temporary solution. Oh, sorry, I drew something down. Hold on. Okay. That is definitely a temporary solution, but it helped relieve some of that tiredness, which can also help with your redness. So I actually have something that I wanted to experiment with my patients with, if you don't mind. It is painless, and we can practice that heating and putting it on your eyes while we do it. So I don't know if you've ever heard of positive affirmations, but I have some here that I've written down where you're essentially sending love to your eyes. So even though your eyes are not 20/20 vision, they're not perfect, right? They still are there. You still can see. That's great. And we should give them some love. And even if they're struggling, we should have some type of compassion for our eyes. They work very, very hard for us every day, all the time. So naturally, they're gonna need a break every once in a while, right? So positive affirmations can really help send good vibes to your eyes. And in theory, it can actually help make your eyesight better. I don't know if this is true or not, so I wanted try it with my patients, and then I wanted to give this to my patients if they're interested, and they can try it for themselves, and maybe when you come in for your appointment next year, the year after that, whenever you show up, we can see how you're doing. Okay, you want to try it? Thank you. Okay, we can try it. Now, I love silly things, and I called it the I Love Affirmations. That was irrelevant, but I'm letting you know anyway. So if you want, what we can do is we can couple this with the relaxation, breathing, putting warm hands on your eyes, and saying these affirmations, okay? So it's up to you whether you want my hands, my hands are clean, if you want them on your eyes, or if you'd rather put your own hands on your eyes, it's up to you. Okay, you're fine with me doing it? Okay, that's good. So if you want to take your glasses off, you can put them in your lap, because I want you nice and relaxed, okay? You don't have to say these affirmations out loud if you don't want to. You can say them in your head, or you can just listen to me saying them. It's up to you. But to begin, I'm going to rub my hands vigorously. I'm going to get them nice and warm for you to help relax your eyes, okay? Now I'm going to go behind you and I'm going to cover your eyes with my hands, okay? Ready? Okay. Now, breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Relax your shoulders, relax your feet. We're gonna begin, okay? I love my eyes. My eyes. clear and beautiful. I see with perfect clarity. My eyes are healthy and strong. I have wide and clear peripheral vision. I can see at small distances clearly. I can see words and images at great distances. They are crisp and clear to me. My eyes feel awake. I'm gonna rub my hands again, get them warm again. Ready? I'm gonna go back in. The skin around my eyes are firm, smooth, and healthy. I see well in both light and darkness. My eyes are straight and move smoothly in all needed directions. My eyes feel good. My vision is perfect. My eyes are relaxed. My eyes focus effortlessly at objects and words near and far. My eyes are comfortably moistened. I rub my hands again. I'm going to flip my page over. Here we go. Last round, okay? Here we go. My eyes heal naturally from any setback. I give them healing energy and love, and they get stronger and healthier every day. My eyes are helpful and aid me in experiencing the beauty of the world, its creatures, and its peoples. My eyelids and eyelashes are clean and protect my eyes daily and successfully. My eyes are the perfect size and shape. They fit and complement my beautiful face completely. I am grateful for my healthy, clear, gorgeous eyes. I am thankful for all the work they do, all for my benefit. My eyes are perfect, and I would not have them any other way. Your eyes feeling now? Good. Yeah. So I'm going to send you home with these, okay? You can try them out if you want. You can practice. Obviously, covering your eyes, you're not going to be able to read them. You can make up your own affirmations. You can maybe listen to them. You can record yourself saying them and then play them back as you're just sitting there and breathing. Whatever works for you. But I would recommend trying these daily if possible. Maybe right before bed, settle your eyes down before you go to sleep and rejuvenate yourself. And honestly, if you want any feedback on how this is working for you, it would be appreciated, because we are interested in complementing our service with these affirmations and hoping that we can aid our patients further that way. So thank you for that. I appreciate your participation. Have you decided if you want glasses from us or if you'd like to go elsewhere? Okay. You want to try elsewhere? That's fine. I will write you your prescription. 1 second. All right. I'm going to get my little prescription pen. This is your prescription. I am going to attach these together so that you don't lose anything. You still have trouble with your eyes. It's going to take a while for your eyes to recuperate, even with the affirmations, even with sleeping well, even without the blue light. It takes a while to heal, right? So I'm going to give you these. Now, these look a little scary. They look very medicinal. But all these are, they're eye drops, and I know they're not your favorite, but they do help, especially when your eyes are really dry. Like, there's sometimes where your eyelids practically stick together because your eyes are so dry. We don't want that, so we need to moisten our eyes if they're struggling. So these are kind of heavy duty ones. Not a lot of the time, there can be a little bit of buildup / irritation from more commercial brands. So these are meant to really help your eyes without the extra crap that you can get in some other eye drops. Which doesn't mean that those other eye drops are going to completely harm your eyes or anything. It's just they might get more easily irritated, and healing might take a little longer than with something like these. Now I'm going to give you just enough to try, because I know that you don't like you said before, you don't like eye drops. So I'm not sure how much you're going to enjoy these, but if you do want a prescription for these at some point in the future, if you find you do enjoy them, please do let us know, because we can get that done for you, okay? So I'm going to give you these. These are meant for you to try. Let us know how they feel. See if they help alleviate any irritation that you're experiencing. If they help hasten the healing process as well. Okay, so we're going to give you these. These are for you. And I'm also going to give you this, which is a cloth. So when you do get your glasses, even though you're not getting them with us, these can help. A microfiber cloth can help clean the gunk off your glasses. There's little bits and pieces, dust, dirt, anything like that. We know that glasses can get dirty very easily. Not everything cleans it, some things smudge it, so it's good to have these along. You can stick in your backpack or purse or something like that and bring it with you. So it's just a gift from us to you. So thank you so much for coming. Thank you for bearing with us in our still moving / construction phase. Thank you for being very patient and for being so willing to try something different and see how those affirmations work for you. Please do feel free to let us know if they work for you, if you're interested in have maybe possibly more or in other alternative complementary methods to try to heal and maintain your eyes and your eyesight. So please do let us know if anything worsens, if maybe the drops irritate your eyes for whatever reason, or you're finding that my suggestions don't help any of the redness or tiredness in your eyes after a while. Give yourself a little while, a couple weeks, to give your eyes time to heal, because they may take a little bit. After you said you've been experiencing this for a while, yeah, so it's gonna take a little bit, but stick with it. It's gonna be fine. If you follow those steps, do the affirmations, rub your hands, put them over your eyes, relax your body, let everything relax, not just your eyes, because if you relax one part of your body, everything else kind of wants to follow. So just try to relax yourself, to get some really good sleep, and you should be well on your way to recovery. There aren't any deep-seated issues behind it. It's literally just wear and tear for you. Yeah. So no worries. So feel free to contact me should you need anything at all. You can drop by, you can call, whatever works for you. My email is on the website as well, so you can always contact me in whatever way you are comfortable. If you need me, if you have questions, anything like that. Okay. All right. Well, good luck finding your new glasses. I'm sure you'll look snazzy that way, right? Oh, by the way, do you have someone to drive you home? Are you getting picked up? The reason I ask is the eye drops that make your pupils larger, so that dilate your eyes, it can cause some temporary blurriness and sensitivity to light. So if you are experiencing any of the symptoms, that's normal, and it does take a couple hours for it to go away. It's not like you couldn't drive, but it's a lot less safe when your eyes are dilated like that, so it helps if somebody is with you. Yeah, so okay, so someone's gonna catch you. That's good. Alright, so you can go to our receptionist and she'll help you get settled to leave. Feel free to contact me should you need anything at all, okay? Well, thank you so much. It was so nice to meet you. It really was. Thank you. Okay, bye-bye. How was your visit? Good. Okay. So we just need a small copay from you and you're good to go. The doctor gave you your prescription already? Okay, that's good. Do you have any questions for us? Okay. So it'll just be a $10 copay. You can pay with card. Credit or debit? Okay. Okay. Do you mind signing the pad in front of you, please? Okay. Beautiful. Here's your card. Would you like a receipt? You want us to email you the receipt? That's fine. What's your email address, please? Okay. All right. So that has been sent to you. It's all set, ready to go. Do you have any questions for us or anything that you need? If you do find you have any questions or you need anything at all, please do let us know. Right. We have our website and you have our contact information. Okay. We have a good day.